So what's the difference between peak pressure and plateau pressure, and why is it important? Let's go find out. Hello there, and welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time here and you want more of this content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below, and if you hit the bell, you'll get notified whenever I release more content. So the pressure in your ventilator is comprised of two parts, the resistive pressure and the elastic pressure. The resistive pressure is that which is encountered when airflow is pushed through the airways. The elastic pressure is that which inflates the lungs and the chest wall. So increasing ventilator pressures must be due to one or both of these. If your patient's airway pressures are going up, there's either a problem with the resistive pressure or the elastic pressure. So let's talk about peak pressure and plateau pressure. So the peak pressure in the ventilator circuit is related to the resistive pressure, and plateau pressure is related to the elastic pressures. So let's look at this diagram to imagine we're ventilating the lung, and we can see here the pressure curve as we do so. At point one, where we're ventilating the lung, and the airway pressure goes up, and you can see that the volume also increases. At point two, during expiration, the pressure goes down and the flow moves in the opposite direction as the air moves out. So, if we understand that the peak pressure is the maximum pressure in the proximal airway at the end of inspiration, we can see this at point four. At point five, we have instigated a breath hold, which can easily be done by most modern ventilators through a simple press of a button. This is the equivalent of occluding the endotracheal tube at the end of expiration. When you do so, the pressure equalizes between the tube and the alveoli, so consequently, plateau pressure is a surrogate for end inspiratory alveolar pressure. I think using the balloon analogy might be useful at this point. Imagine you're blowing up a normal balloon. As you inflate the balloon, blowing quite hard, this equates to the peak pressure. Imagine then that you stop blowing, but keep the balloon in your mouth. The pressure then equalizes between your airway and inside the balloon. This pressure will not need to be as high as when you are actually inflating the balloon, and this therefore equates to plateau pressure. So peak pressure is dependent upon the resistance in the airways and also on the compliance of the lungs. If the airway resistance is high or the lungs have become stiff, then the peak pressure will rise. The plateau pressure, however, is only related to the compliance of the lungs. In other words, how stiff those lungs are. Let's look quickly at these two examples. In this example, you can see that there is a high peak pressure. If the difference between the peak pressure and the plateau pressure is greater than 5 millimeters of mercury, then it is defined as an elevated peak pressure. In the next diagram, you can see that there is an elevated plateau pressure. So what can this tell us? Well, if we have a high peak pressure, there is possibly an airway issue. For example, we may have a bronchospasm, retained secretions, mucus plug, or the endotracheal tube tip might be blocked, or it might be sitting against the wall of the bronchus, for example. If we have a high plateau pressure, and remember this is related to the compliance of the lung, we may have a pneumothorax, pulmonary edema, ARDS, or a pneumonia. So if we can understand the difference between peak and plateau pressure, we may be able to diagnose what's wrong with our patient's ventilation, and consequently, what we might be able to do to improve it. Please remember to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell button as well, and you'll get notified whenever I produce a new video. Thanks for watching.